We will first do some questions. Be ready with you with a pen or pencil and a notebook, right? As a matter of fact, you should be ready always with a notebook and a pen or pencil. Okay, so you will try to write down the answer. If I ask you to read the answer, you will read the answer. So first of all, we'll begin the class by chanting Omkaram 3 times. So all of you, join your hands, close your eyes, and chant Omkaram 3 times. So as I told you, let me first show your questions from metals and non-metal chapter. Okay. So you see very short answer questions first. Okay. So can you see the screen, beta? Akshat?
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Beta. Anna, you will be talking to me. Right? So your question number one, note down. These questions are very, very important questions. Maybe ask in your any examination, periodic test, unit test, whatever. Anna? Annual examination. So question is this, I'm reading, you note down. Why is it not advisable to store silver nitrate solution in copper vessel? Okay. So write the answer also. Be ready with your answer. Anyone can answer?
All this has come to me.
Yeah. Who is ready with the answer? Chat box, write why. Anyone who is ready with the answer, write why in the chat box. No one. So, should I give the answer? Akshat, can you, beta? Parth, Vats and Anmur joined. Okay. Sairam, Parth. So, again see the question. Parth is joining right now. Beta, join before 3. At least 5 minutes earlier. 2:55. Right? Again see the question. If someone of you have not seen the question, again write the question. Why is it not advisable to store silver nitrate solution in copper vessel? Okay. Anyone done?
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, because copper can react with it.
So copper will react with silver nitrate solution. Why?
So because copper is more reactive than it.
Good, very good. Copper is more reactive than silver because if you will see the reactivity series, where is copper and where is silver? Silver is below copper. And in fact, copper, then mercury and then silver. So copper is above silver in the reactivity series. So copper is more reactive than silver. So it will react and it will displace silver, right? So by and by your silver vessel will be lost, right? So note, you can see the solution. Later on you can note down from it from a video also. See the answer. Copper is more reactive metal than silver. Therefore, it will react with silver nitrate solution and displace silver from silver nitrate solution. Then, let us go ahead. Akshat? Akshat, you will talk to me.
Yes, sir.
Move ahead. Jor se bolo thoda beta.
Yes, question. Sir.
Now, why are immersion rods for heating liquids are made up of metals?
Sir, because metals are good conductors of heat and electricity.
First, write down why in the chat box. Then I will call the name and that student will answer. Okay. So right now, let Parth answer. Parth was.
Sir, metal are the conductor of heat.
Heat and electricity, both beta. Immersion rod. If it is a bad conductor of electricity, it will not work. Okay, good. So see the answer. Immersion rods are for heating liquids are made up of metals because metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Next question. Define the term ductility. Who will give the answer? Write Y in the chat box. Write Y in the chat box. Chat box. Who has written? Okay, Pranjal. Rudraksh, answer please.
Sir, metals can be beaten and drawn into thin wires.
Yeah. Okay, good. But also learn how to write in a better way. Okay, beta. See, it is the property of metals due to which they can be drawn into wires. Okay. Next question. Define the term malleability. Write Y in the chat box. Define the term malleability. Akshat, Parth, Adyasha. Okay, Adyasha, can you?
The property of metals by which they can be beaten into thin sheets is called malleability.
Yes, perfectly fine. Very good. You see the answer? It is the property of metals due to which they can be beaten into sheets by hammering or by applying pressure. In fact, when you apply pressure also, they can be beaten into sheets. Right? Very good. Next question. What is malleability? What is malleability? So just now we have seen property of metals by which they can be beaten into thin sheets is called malleability. This is a definition. That was application based. Next question. Zinc can displace copper from a salt solution. Why? Yes, Akshat. Akshat? No.
Yes, sir.
Can you answer this question?
Sir, I don't know.
See the question. Zinc can displace copper from its, means copper sulfate solution. Why?
Sir?
Sir, because it is more reactive than copper.
Because zinc is more reactive than copper.
Yes,
okay. See the answer. Zinc can displace copper from a salt solution because zinc is more reactive than copper from its salt solution. Okay. Why cooking utensils are made up of metals? Okay, Parth. Yes, Parth.
Sir, because they are conductors of heat.
Good. They are good conductors of heat. Yeah. The answer is cooking utensils are made up of metals because metals are good conductors of heat. Okay, done. Right, now you will note down the question and you will do the answer at your home and then we discuss later on, you will answer. Okay, these are short answer type questions. So note down these questions. Okay, note down. What would happen to iron railings on roadside if they are not painted? Why does it so happen? Give reaction. Reaction you can give in word reaction or chemical equation form. Then next question. You can note down this from a video also, beta. So we can save our time. What do you suggest? Tell me. Should I show the question and read it? That will be sufficient. You can note down these questions from the video sent. Can you do that?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Beta, that will save our time. So, Next question. What is a displacement reaction? Give one example. These questions will give you an insight. How should I prepare? Whether I am prepared or not. Hanumita, that will help you a lot. Next question. A person bought a statue made of copper. To his surprise, it acquired a dull green coating after a couple of months. Explain the reason. These are very, very important questions, beta. Reasoning in science, very important questions. Okay. Next question. How will carbon and sulfur react with oxygen? What happens when their products are dissolved in water? Okay. Next question. What is rust? How does rusting of iron take place? This you have learnt in class 7 also. Mention few exceptions in metals. Few metals which are exceptions. What do you observe when rust dissolved in water is subjected to litmus test? When rust has taken place, you dissolve the rust in water and you test with litmus paper. What will you get the result? What happens when iron nail is dipped in copper sulfate solution? Next question. Define any two properties of metals. Okay. So be ready with the answer of these questions in my next class. And you remind me. Okay, beta, will you do that, Akshat?
Yes, sir.
All of you should be ready with the answers. I can take the name of any one of you and you will have to answer, beta. Okay, if you have difficulty, you can, of course, tell that, right? So,
yes, sir.
Should answer. If not, I will answer. Hana beta? Okay, so now our topic. Right, beta? Coal and petroleum. Coal and petroleum. Of course, coal and petroleum. Then we have seen certain videos, right? Chemistry of coal and petroleum. Let us see once more through video. Right, beta? Once again, we'll solidify what we have learnt about coal. Then we'll move to petroleum.
Hello friends, this video on coal and petroleum part 1. Hello friends, this video on coal and petroleum part 1 is brought to you.
Amita, sound is proper or I should increase the sound?
Sir, increase the sound. Sir,
increase the sound.
Increase the sound. Okay, now tell me, whatever, if any problem you tell, otherwise continue.
No more fear from exam. Topics to be covered in this lesson are introduction, natural resources, exhaustible natural resources, inexhaustible natural resources, coal, petroleum, natural gas, judicious use of natural resources. So what are natural resources? The name says natural resources, the resources which exist in nature. So these are those substances that exist in nature and they are useful to mankind. So,
okay, note down this. What are natural resources? Substances that exist in nature and useful to mankind are called natural resources.
So these substances, we cannot create them artificially. So even if we want to create them, we can't. And they tend to exist, they tend to form in nature by themselves. And they are extremely useful to mankind in many different ways. Most of them act as wonderful sources of energy. So some of the examples of natural resources are soil. And we all know how important soil is. The growth and development of plants, they are all directly dependent on soil. Soil is rich in minerals. So there is an entire ecosystem which exists within the soil. There are so many different types of living organisms living inside the soil. Soil is one such natural resource. Air. We live because we are able to breathe in. And what do we breathe? We breathe air. So air, which is present around us, is something which is extremely important for the survival of all types of living organisms. And do you think that we can create air? No, air is something which exists naturally. Water is another such natural resource. Forests, wildlife. So these are all examples of natural resources. Some other examples of natural resources: coal, petroleum. So these are also natural resources because we cannot create coal, we cannot create petroleum. So in this lesson, our agenda is to talk in more detail about these two natural resources, that is coal and petroleum. So we will see that how they are beneficial to us, how do they help us. Now, just to tell you in brief, so you would have often seen that coal is being used to, when you burn coal, you get a lot of fire, you get a lot of heat, and that heat energy is utilized for many different purposes. For example, it is used for cooking purpose. Coal is also used for generation of electricity. So the heat energy of the coal is transformed into electric energy. So that's how the energy is utilized. Petroleum, there are so many products which are obtained from petroleum, like petrol, diesel, kerosene, and all of them are useful to mankind. So these types of resources are called natural resources. Now the question is, why do we talk about managing resources? Why do you would have often seen people saying that we should take good care of the natural resources, we should try to not waste them, we should try to preserve them. So why do we talk about resource management? Because the resources are limited.
It's very important, why should we manage our resources? Right? Resources are limited.
Not all resources, but those resources which take a long time to be formed, we can say that they are limited. Now, if you take examples of resources like air, water, or coal, petroleum, so if you compare these resources, so when you look at the availability of air, you feel that there is so much of air around us. So why do we really need to manage air? Because already plenty of it is available. Now, if you talk about coal or petroleum, but do you know how coal is formed, how petroleum is formed? So it is actually a very time-consuming process. It takes millions of years for coal or petroleum to form. So now, when you are able to prepare something over millions of years, so you should not let that exhaust within a couple of years. So managing the resources is also important so that we can ensure equal distribution of resources to all. Now, if you see the resources, as we said, a lot of resources are limited. So now when you have something which is in limited stock, so we need to ensure that everybody gets equal share of it. Otherwise, what will happen? All of it will get consumed by a certain group of people, and some other group of people will remain deprived of it. So that means we need to ensure that these resources, especially the ones which are limited, which cannot be created over and again, so those resources should be distributed equally. Protect the environment, because making use of these resources also harm the environment in a certain way. For example, usage of coal, petroleum, so these kind of things, when they are burned, a lot of pollution is also caused to the environment. So we also need to take care that the resources are being used in such a way so that the environment remains protected. So these are some of the reasons because of which we talk about managing the natural resources.
Okay, Maria. So this is the first part. Now we have learnt about coal. So what can you see, Akshat, on the screen?
PPT, petroleum.
Petroleum, okay, beta. So today we'll start this petroleum, because we all know that petrol is used as a fuel, right? When you buy drive your scooty, your papa drives your car, it is run by petrol, right? Heavy motor vehicles like trucks and tractors are run by diesel. Petrol and diesel are obtained from a natural resource which is called petroleum. Okay, let us learn more about petroleum. How was petroleum formed? ओके बेटा, पेट्रोलियम, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ पेट्रोलियम, राइट? पेट्रोलियम वॉज फॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम ऑर्गेनिजम्स लिविंग इन द सी. रिमेंबर, एज दीज ऑर्गेनिजम्स डाइड, देयर बॉडीज सेटल्ड एट द बॉटम ऑफ द सी एंड गॉट कन्वर्टेड, गॉट कवर्ड विथ लेयर्स ऑफ सैंड एंड क्ले. And over millions of years, absence of air, high temperature, and high pressure transformed the dead organisms into petroleum and natural gas. Actually, in the sea, there are lots of phytoplanktons and zooplanktons. And beta, macroscopic plants are called phytoplanktons, and macroscopic organisms in the sea, they are called zooplanktons. So remember, coal is 100% plant product. But petroleum is a product of both plants and animals. Okay, beta. Now, petroleum and natural gas both occurs inside the earth crust in the form of deposits. And you can see the picture. Anna, this is a reservoir rock, and this is water, and on water floats oil. This is called crude oil or petroleum, and upon that gas is there, and it is trapped in between two impervious rocks. Impervious means non-porous rocks, right? And these are the wells which are drilled, and then these are mined, they are taken out. This figure is in the book also. Now see, what is actually petroleum? If it is asked what is petroleum, then you can write down, petroleum is a dark oily liquid which has an unpleasant odor or a smell. It is a mixture of various constituents such as petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, etc. But all these are present in petroleum or crude oil. So how can we take out all the, right? That is very, very important. So the process of separating the various constituents, which is also called fractions of petroleum, is known as refining. So we have to do refining, right? And how it is done? Refining of petroleum is done in a petroleum refinery. There is a refinery where this is done. And this is done by which method? Fractional distillation. Which method? Akshat? Akshat Sharma? Refining of petroleum is done by which method? Anybody else? Adhisa?
Fractional distillation.
And you can see this diagram, this is a petroleum refinery. Aur hamare aas paas koi batayega kahan par hai petrol refinery?
The plant mein.
Sir, NFL.
NFL mein refinery nahi, petroleum nahi beta. Wahan to ammonia ka plant hai jahan fertilizer banta hai. Naam suna hai Bina, BINA?
Yes sir.
Yes, Bina mein refinery hai beta apna. है ना, जब when Dr. मनमोहन सिंह वाज आवर प्राइम मिनिस्टर, वो उद्घाटन करने आए थे, इनॉग्रेशन करने आए थे बीना का, है ना? आपके कोई परिवार वाले बीना रिफाइनरी में काम करते हैं तो उनसे संवाद करना, टॉक टू देम, दे विल टेल यू मोर अबाउट दैट. सो लेट अस सी वन वीडियो हाउ दिस इज डन, देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू, राइट बेटा? आर यू रेडी?
यस सर.
वुड यू लाइक अ वीडियो शोइंग फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन ऑफ पेट्रोलियम? How are we obtaining different fractions like petrol, diesel, fuel, oil, and all these? Let's go ahead.
Grammarly does more than catch errors. With Grammarly, you can find.
Good morning, children. Today we shall learn about petroleum and its usage. Like coal, petroleum is also a fossil fuel, which means it
okay,
is...
Okay, beta, is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Listen carefully. Note down the questions.
Formed from the remains of dead organisms. But it is liquid, as the process of its formation was much different from the formation of coal. Petroleum was formed from the remains of sea creatures. As they died, their body settled at the bottom of sea or ocean and gradually got covered by sand, clay, etc. Over millions of years, absence of air, high temperature and high pressure transform the dead organisms into petroleum and natural gas. All of us know how important petrol, diesel, etc. are. We get this fuel from petroleum. We also get kerosene from petroleum. Petroleum needs to be refined in the refineries to get these fuels. Raw petroleum or crude oil is a dark, oily liquid with an unpleasant smell. It is extracted from Earth's crust through a deep oil well. A huge pump extracts the petroleum through this deep oil well. Petroleum is a complex mixture. Petroleum refining means separating its components, and it is carried out at petroleum refineries. This separation process is known as fractional distillation. This process is actually for separating chemical components by their boiling point. Mixture is heated to a temperature.
Remember beta, boiling point is very important. See, this is a very tall fractionating column, and in this one there are, you can see, some compartments, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so many compartments are there. And you can see there is a cap on at this one. This is called bubble cap or bell cap, right beta? So first of all, petroleum is heated in a furnace and it is converted into vapor, and the vapor is allowed to go into this tall column. So what happens? Because of pressure, the bell caps open and vapor goes into this compartment, and the vapor having higher boiling point, it converts into condense and converts into liquid and comes out. And those components which do not liquefy, it goes into another compartment, because once the cap open, vapor can go out. But when there is no pressure from inside, cap is closed. Okay, so now see how it is explained.
Which one or more fractions of the compound will vaporize. Look, different components vaporize at different temperature and thus get separated. So we get lots of things from petroleum. We get fuels like petrol, kerosene, diesel, LPG, etc. We get lubricating oil. Paraffin wax, which we get from the residue of the refining process, is used for making ointments, candles, petroleum jelly, face cream, wax, etc. Bitumen, which is also obtained from residue of fractional distillation process, is used for making paint and building roads. Every component of petroleum has some use, hence it is often called black gold. Natural gas is a very important fuel because it is easy to transport through the pipes. Natural gas is stored under high pressure as compressed natural gas, in short CNG. CNG is used for generating power as fuel for cars. CNG is less polluting than petrol, diesel, etc. But coal, petroleum, natural gas, etc. aren't available in unlimited quantity. With heavy use of these, we will run out of these resources in not so distant future. So these are exhaustible natural resources. Hence, we have turned to resources which are available in unlimited quantity for fuel, electricity production, etc.
Okay, my dear. So we have seen about petroleum. Any question, beta? Now what is there on the screen? Akshat?
Sir, you are seeing.
I am only.
Nahi sir, sab dikh rahe hain.
All of you are can, yeah. Okay, beta. So let us learn little more about it.
Sir.
Yes. Tell me.
Sir, a question tha.
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, refined oil मतलब sunflower oil होता है ना?
हाँ सुनो बेटा, refined oil means not only sunflower oil, right? See, refined means when any oil seeds they are pressed, they are filtered again and again, and then they are sold. That is called refined oil, right, beta? So that name is there, common name refined oil. It can be refined soybean oil, refined sunflower oil, refined rice bran oil. Refined means not only that, beta. Okay, it's common word. It is refined means it is filtered again and again, and in purified form it is there. That it is called refined. Okay.
Yes.
Huh. Yes. So now, let us see the second part. Is petroleum? Is fractional distillation completed? Now see beta, various constituents of petroleum and their usage. You have to memorize this. And for this I can show you from your book also. Anna, just see your NCERT book. Anna, can you find? Here it is. Yeah, this is page number 60. देखो बेटा ये कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स ऑफ पेट्रोलियम यूजेज पेट्रोलियम गैस इन लिक्विड फॉर्म इज कॉल्ड एलपीजी लिक्विफाइड पेट्रोलियम गैस इज यूज फॉर फ्यूल एंड फॉर होम एंड इंडस्ट्री पेट्रोल पेट्रोल मोटर फ्यूल एविएशन फ्यूल सॉल्वेंट फॉर ड्राई क्लीनिंग व्हेन यू सेंड योर कोट और मामा साड़ी फॉर ड्राई क्लीनिंग इट इज वॉश विद पेट्रोल बिकॉज डर्ट दे आर organic in nature, so they get dissolved in petrol and it is removed from the cloth. Kerosene used for fuel for stoves, lamps and for jet aircrafts. High grade kerosene is used in jet aircrafts. Diesel used for heavy motor vehicles, truck hai na, tractors bhari gaadi hote hain unko chalane ke liye, tanks, electric generators, lubricating oil lubrication purpose, hai na? That is, you put grease oil in your bicycle so that it runs very well. For purpose it is lubricating oil. Paraffin wax, it is used for making ointments, jo malham lagate hain dawaiyon mein, candles, vaseline, aap jitne lagate hain, lip balm, lip guard, thand ke dinon mein, uska main product paraffin wax hai, right? Usme thoda sa एरोमेटिक सब्सटेंसेज सुगंध वाली चीजें मिला देते हैं तो अच्छा देख सुगंध लगता है लेकिन पैराफिन वैक्स होगा ना थोड़ा पेट्रोलियम की गंध आएगी उसमें बिटुमेन वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट इट पेंट्स एंड रोड सर्फेसिंग में आजकल यूज होता है ओके सो एनी क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग यूजेज ऑफ पेट्रोलियम प्रोडक्ट्स एंड मोर ओवर रिमेंबर फ्रॉम पेट्रोलियम वी ऑल्सो ऑब्टेन मेनी सब्सटेंसेज which are used as a starting material for making many substances. And the chemicals obtained from petroleum and its products are called petrochemicals, beta. Yaad rakhiyega. Petrochemicals. Hai na? Many useful substances are obtained from petroleum and natural gas. These are termed as petrochemicals. Note down. These are used in the manufacture of detergents. Jo aaj hum kapde dhone mein use karte hain. है ना बेटा फाइबर्स पॉलिएस्टर नाइलॉन एक्रेलिक फॉर दीज द रॉ मटेरियल्स दे आर ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम पेट्रोलियम एंड प्रोडक्ट कॉल्ड पेट्रोकेमिकल्स पॉलीथीन एंड अदर मैनमेड प्लास्टिक्स हाइड्रोजन गैस ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम नेचुरल गैस इज यूज इन द पेट्रोल प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर्स यू नो अगर आप जाएंगे NFL तो NFL में क्या बनाते हैं डू यू नो दिस In NFL,
sir, ammonia
gas. And for the production of ammonia, what do we need?
Sir, urea.
नहीं बेटा, अमोनिया बनाने के लिए दो चीज चाहिए, बताया था मैंने पहले भी, नाइट्रोजन चाहिए, नाइट्रोजन गैस एंड वन मोर गैस इज नीडेड. टेल मी, हाइड्रोजन है ना बेटा, एंड दोनों कंबाइन करते हैं अंडर हाई प्रेशर, हाई टेम्परेचर एंड विद सम कैटलिस्ट, देन इट फॉर्म्स अमोनिया. अमोनिया का बहुत बड़ा प्लांट है वहां पर, एक कन्वर्टर है उसमें ये होता है. अभी जाओ NFL, दो लगा दो तो हाइड्रोजन सिक्स हो गया, यहाँ थ्री लगाना पड़ेगा, है ना, ये बैलेंस हो गया. ये अमोनिया गैस है और ये बनता है तो टूट भी जाता है, इसलिए तुरंत इसको पानी में डाल के डिजोल्व करते हैं. इट इज हाईली सॉल्युबल इन वाटर बेटा. तो अमोनिया बनाने के लिए दो गैस चाहिए, एक तो चाहिए क्या बोलो जल्दी, वन इज नीडेड, विच वन?
नाइट्रोजन एंड हाइड्रोजन,
अदर वन इज हाइड्रोजन. तो हाउ डज NFL मैनेज टू गेट नाइट्रोजन? NFL नाइट्रोजन कहाँ से लाता है?
सर एयर.
हाँ, एयर से लेता है, वेरी गुड. पहले एयर को कंप्रेस करते हैं बार बार बेटा, है ना, एंड वी डू नॉट अलाउ द टेम्परेचर टू राइज, एंड देन इट बिकम्स एयर, बिकम्स लिक्विड एयर. एट दैट टाइम टू गैस इज प्रेजेंट ओनली, नाइट्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन, बाकी सब गैस हट जाते हैं क्योंकि ये ज्यादा है दोनों, है ना बेटा, ये 78% और ऑक्सीजन 21%. इसके बाद क्या करते हैं, इसका फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन करते हैं, फिर उसमें से नाइट्रोजन सेपरेट हो जाता है, दैट नाइट्रोजन इज सेंट इनटू द कन्वर्टर. एंड हाउ डज NFL मैनेज हाइड्रोजन? NFL हाइड्रोजन कहां से लाती है? एनीबॉडी? नहीं मालूम है
सर, वाटर.
देखो बेटा, ये हमारा गेल प्लांट है ना, वन ऑफ द रीजन व्हाई गेल इज हियर बिकॉज ऑफ NFL. गेल गिव्स नेचुरल गैस टू NFL. क्या देती है गेल उसको? नेचुरल गैस, जिसमें मोस्टली क्या होता है, मीथेन होता है. मीथेन फॉर्मूला क्या होता है? CH4, द सिंपलेस्ट हाइड्रोकार्बन. व्हाट आर हाइड्रोकार्बन? हु विल टेल मी व्हाट आर हाइड्रोकार्बन्स? एनीवन?
सो द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स ऑफ कार्बन,
सर हाइड्रोजन और कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड.
कंपाउंड्स ऑफ कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन आर कॉल्ड हाइड्रोकार्बन्स. नोट डाउन, कंपाउंड्स ऑफ हाइड्रोकार्बन, हाइड्रो हाइड्रोजन कार्बन कार्बन, सो कंपाउंड्स ऑफ टू एलिमेंट्स हाइड्रोजन कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन आर कॉल्ड हाइड्रोकार्बन, एंड दिस इज द सिंपलेस्ट हाइड्रोकार्बन, मीथेन. मीथेन है ना. नेक्स्ट ग्रुप, नेक्स्ट 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 मेंबर क्या होगा इसका, बताओ एनीवन कैन टेल मी? मीथेन के आगे कौन सा नंबर है
सर? इथेन.
हाँ, मीथेन, इथेन. फिर मिलेगा प्रोपेन, ब्यूटेन, पेंटेन, हेक्सेन, हेप्टेन, ऑक्टेन, नोनेन, डेकेन, है ना, और फॉर्मूला ऐसे बढ़ता जाएगा, CH4 का डिफरेंस आता रहेगा. ओके बेटा, सो हाइड्रोजन इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम नेचुरल गैस, है ना, बाय स्टीम रिफॉर्मिंग प्रोसेस, एंड दिस इज गेल सेंड द गैस टू NFL और NFL वाले उससे निकालते हैं हाइड्रोजन गैस. तो अभी आपने देखा वेर वी वेर PPT ना, या यूजेज ऑफ पेट्रोलियम है ना एंड नेचुरल गैस, एक्चुअली इन द बुक है ना, ये देखो बेटा, है ना. हाइड्रोजन गैस ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम नेचुरल गैस इज यूज इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर, यूरिया बनाते हैं वहाँ. ड्यू टू दिस ग्रेट कमर्शियल इंपॉर्टेंस पेट्रोलियम इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ब्लैक गोल्ड. नोट डाउन, क्वेश्चन आ सकता है, रीजन गिव रीजंस फॉर व्हाई इज पेट्रोलियम कॉल्ड ब्लैक गोल्ड. ओके बेटा, सो नाउ टेल मी अबाउट पेट्रोलियम, एनी क्वेश्चन?
नो सर.
नो. सो नेचुरल गैस, लास्ट पार्ट नेचुरल गैस विल स्टडी इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. यस बेटा, बोलो पिंकी और कृष्णा, एनीबडी
बोलना हो क्वेश्चन को?
पिंकी
हां सर, रिपीट सर वो क्वेश्चन को एक बार और बोलना.
व्हिच क्वेश्चन बेटा?
सर वो पेट्रोलियम,
पेट्रोलियम
सर, व्हाई पेट्रोलियम?
हां सर, व्हाई पेट्रोलियम इज कॉल्ड ब्लैक गोल्ड. See the book, book देखो मेरा, है ना बेटा, last line देखो, last line. दिख रहा है स्क्रीन आपको पिंकी ये पूरी थी कौन थी
यस सर
देखो लास्ट लाइन ब्लैक गोल्ड व्हाई इज पेट्रोलियम कॉल्ड ब्लैक गोल्ड ओके बेटा लास्ट पार्ट इज नेचुरल गैस नेचुरल गैस अलग से इसको नेचुरल गैस को बनाने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती बेटा इट इज फॉर्म्ड अलोंग विद पेट्रोलियम सो अगर पूछेगा राइट द स्टोरी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ नेचुरल गैस किसका लिखना आपको है आदेशा फॉर्मेशन ऑफ पेट्रोलियम पेट्रोलियम के साथ ही नेचुरल गैस ही बनता है आपने देखा होगा डायग्राम था मैंने आपको पहले पानी नीचे होता है इसके ऊपर क्या फ्लोट करता है पेट्रोलियम बिकॉज इट इज ऑयल है बेटा क्रूड ऑयल और उसके ऊपर गैस डिपॉजिट रहता है
यस सर
यू आर आस्क्ड हाउ इज नेचुरल गैस फॉर्म्ड बट राइट डाउन मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स अगो द सी क्रिएचर्स माइक्रोस्कोपिक प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स व्हेन दे डाइड दे गॉट डिपॉजिटेड अंडर द सी बेड एंड दे वर प्रेस्ड विद फ्रेश सेडिमेंट्स एंड दिस गॉट They go on sinking down and down and down, and at a certain depth, because of high temperature, high pressure, and due to some catalytic action, the organic matter converted into petroleum and natural gas. Okay, beta? So this is the process, right? So natural gas is a very important fossil fuel. Acha, why it is a fossil fuel? Why is natural gas?
It is obtained from fossils of
because it is also obtained from fossils which are the dead remains of plants and animals got preserved for millions of years ago okay beta and natural gas ka ek form hai CNG compressed natural gas note down underline kar lo beta full form CNG is used for power generation अभी CNG से हम इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्रोड्यूस करते हैं जला करके नाउ इट इज यूज्ड एज अ फ्यूल फॉर ट्रांसपोर्ट व्हीकल्स अभी आप दिल्ली जाओगे है ना तो आपको वहां पर जितने भी ऑटो मिलेंगे सब में ग्रीन ग्रीन कलर का पेंट क्या मिलेगा एंड दीज ऑटो आई मीन डजंट कॉज मच पोल्यूशन बिकॉज दे ऑल आर रन ऑन CNG से सारे CNG चलते हैं बेटा एंड CNG इज लेस पोल्यूटिंग बिकॉज इट बर्न्स कंप्लीटली एंड इट रिलीजेस वेरी स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ polluting gases hai na beta right dekho yes, because it is less polluting it is a cleaner fuel and the great advantage is that it can be directly sent through pipelines and kahin bhi supply kar sakte hain aaj dekho those who are living in gale campus un sab ke quarter mein gas aa rahi nahi aa rahi hai
yes sir
this gas is natural gas actually पीएनजी पाइप नेचुरल गैस है ना बेटा तो पाइप से हम दूर दूर अभी कोशिश भी हो रही है बेटा गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज ट्राइंग टू सेट द नेटवर्क ऑफ डिफरेंट सिटीज दे ऑल विल बी कनेक्टेड एंड डायरेक्टली थ्रू पाइप गैस विल बी सेंड टू देयर होम्स सिम छोटा सा मीटर लगा होगा कितना गैस जलाया आपने इतना का बिल आपके पास आ जाएगा बोलो बेटा कुछ पूछ रहे थे कोई आप है ना Somebody was asking some question. Akshat,
no,
time
sir.
is over, right? So next time I will show you some video regarding formation of petroleum, natural gas, and their usage, and then we'll do the exercises, right? Na? And so we'll conclude by chanting Shanti Path. Let me take the attendance also. शांति पाठ बेटा शांति 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 साई राम
साई राम
सर हु लीव्स इन बिटवीन विल नॉट गेट द अटेंडेंस बेटा डू नॉट लीव विदाउट माय परमिशन